Moving from IRE to IC, how do you design and lead instructional conversations that create an active learning community in your classroom? Many of us are familiar with the traditional pattern of discourse called IRE, or Initiation Response Evaluation. This method limits students' thinking. It's not as effective or meaningful as IC, or Instructional Conversation, which activates critical thinking and student agency. In this presentation, you'll learn the differences between the two methods and when they do and don't work. In your classroom discourse, what types of thinking and comprehension do your questions require of your students? The IRE and IC methods require different levels of student thinking. If you use the IRE method, here is what your classroom conversation might look like. Number one, you ask a closed question to which you already know the answer. Number two, your students must respond with a brief but correct response, proving that they know certain facts. And three, then you respond with an evaluation such as good, that's right, or that's incorrect. Let's listen to an example of IRE in action. What type of thinking are these students, Henry and Bianca, engaging in? Okay, so you have in front of you an essay called A Modest Proposal. What do we know about the author, Jonathan Swift? Henry.
He was a writer in like the 1700s.
Good, good. Anyone else? Any other facts we know about Jonathan Swift? Bianca.
He wrote this essay in 1729.
Yes, true. That's a good try. But how's something else? Henry.
He was Irish and pretty mad at the British. He wrote satire.
Oh, good, good, good. Excellent. That's right. Okay, now let's read this essay and look for things he's satirizing. So let's process what you just heard. With initiation response evaluation discourse, you hear the following elements. The teacher controls discussion with closed questions. The teacher does more of the talking. The students engage in this type of thinking, recalling, reciting, listing, and/or labeling. Students think on the first levels of Bloom's taxonomy, the knowledge and comprehension levels. And finally, the teacher may privilege or reward the student with the right answer versus the student with the wrong answer. So, when should you use IRE? Note that the sample conversation you just heard is not a bad or wrong conversation for a teacher to lead sometimes. The IRE method, which relies on knowledge and comprehension questions, can be a brief and effective informal assessment of what some students know about a topic, just as a multiple choice quiz can be a diagnostic. For example, you might use the IRE method to quickly review basic facts that provide context for a reading assignment. What the IRE method can't do is foster complex critical thinking. This method does not encourage student construction of knowledge. The IRE method does not allow for open-ended, big-picture questions that drive meaningful conversation. Therefore, this method should not be your standard strategy for classroom discourse. It's a dead end with a few answers already known by the teacher. It's not designed to promote conversation that leads to greater exploration, understanding, and discovery. If you use the IC method, or instructional conversation, here is what your classroom discourse might look like. Number one, you ask an open-ended question which has several answers and the potential for complex discussion and debate. Number two, your students must respond with thinking that applies, analyzes, synthesizes, or evaluates information and concepts. Number three, you respond with more questions that ask students to elaborate, connect, seek evidence, and refine their arguments. You respond with directives to do further research. Four, you offer feedback that guides the process and strategies and that helps students clarify their thinking. And number five, you offer minimal evaluation. Let's listen to an example of IC in action. What type of thinking are these students engaging in? So, yesterday we learned the definition of satire and we watched some TV clips of modern political satire. Then you went home and took notes on a biography of Jonathan Swift and on a historical timeline of events in England and Ireland. You had to generate your best answers as you explored the focus question that you're now going to discuss with your partner. Turn to your partner and discuss this. Why would Jonathan Swift write satire? What angered him? You can use your timeline notes to answer it. Okay, so everyone's had time comparing and combining answers with their partners. Partnership number one, what's your argument?
Okay, England basically ran Ireland for about 500 years before he, Jonathan Swift, wrote the satire.
Interesting. Can you guys explain further? What do you mean by England ran Ireland?
Well, the Irish people were really poor, and Swift was Irish.
Good, good. So you're raising evidence of an economic problem. How was poverty caused by England having political power over Ireland?
We both read that the English put trade restrictions on Ireland. Oh, and it says in the biography that Swift was mad about the English banks pulling money out of Ireland and the landlords getting all the money.
Excellent. So how about another partnership? Why don't you help us answer by building on what partnership number one just said. In what other ways did England run Ireland?
Well, there was the religious thing. England was Protestant, Ireland was Catholic, so there was there were religious differences, I guess, between the governments. But it says here he was a Protestant, so why would he be mad about the religious differences? He had, a high position in the Protestant church.
Excellent question. Okay, everyone, take a look at your timeline and biography and see if you can figure out the answer to this great question that this partnership just raised. With instructional conversation discourse, you see the following features. The teacher facilitates discussion with open-ended questions for which there are multiple and complex answers. The students do more of the talking. The students engage in this type of thinking, analysis, synthesis, and evaluation. The conversation is ongoing, investigative, and student-led. All students are co-creators of knowledge. The topic can be interdisciplinary because knowledge is expansive and stretches across disciplinary guidelines. So, when should you use IC? The IC method, which relies on analysis, synthesis, and evaluation questions, should be the regular language of classroom discourse. This method uses open-ended, big-picture questions that drive meaningful conversation and lead to more investigation. In the example you just heard, the students are learning that satire can be an author's rhetorical response to vice and corruption as it presents in politics and institutions. They're also learning that Jonathan Swift and Irish-English politics of the 1700s cannot be simply or easily labeled. The IC method leads students through discourse of complex critical thinking and student construction of knowledge. Instead of a dead end, students are moving through several options, a roundabout, to investigate interesting possibilities using evidence and reasoning. Here's a checklist to help you gauge when your discourse is an instructional conversation. Is the conversation focused on a topic, theme, or issue that intellectually engages students? Does it involve as many students as possible? Does it ask students to clearly articulate their thoughts and reasoning behind their thinking? Does the teacher clarify the student's thinking, asking for evidence? Does it connect student thinking to prior knowledge and other students' knowledge, inviting students to build on one another's contributions? When you think about the differences between the IRE and IC examples you just heard, you may have noted already that the IC example happened in a greater context, a before, during, and after model of instruction. Note that students were in day two of a unit that began with a definition of and modern examples of satire, and where the students had already annotated historical information about the political context for Swift's satire and his biography as part of the preparation for the reading of A Modest Proposal. On this particular day, students were analyzing the historical context for Swift's satire before reading A Modest Proposal. You can assume that students will read and annotate some of the essay in answer to these questions. What is Swift angriest about, and how do you know? And what rhetorical strategies does he use to persuade his audience? The students will then conclude this unit by writing a satire of their own, using rhetorical strategies of hyperbole, incongruity, and irony. Do you see how the questions that focus students' reading comprehension are high level while being grounded in knowledge and comprehension level information? Do you see how the unit is geared towards students creating new knowledge by the end? And do you see how the investigation of an essential question threads continuously through this lesson design, leading to a student product or performance that answers this open-ended question? In the next phase of this module, you will explore language for ensuring instructional conversation, as well as see how some teachers promote classroom discourse. This language and strategy will help you lead students through in-depth investigation of the readings and the subjects you teach.